Welcome to this tutorial session. In this, we will have practice on numerical problems related to Breton cycle. Okay, so let me first discuss our first problem, what we are having for today. So in the first problem, we have a gas turbine power plant which is operating on ideal Breton cycle. So this particular gas turbine power plant is actually operating on ideal Breton cycle. It has pressure ratio of 8. The gas temperature is 300 Kelvin at the compressor inlet and 1300 Kelvin at the turbine inlet. Okay. By utilizing the air standard assumptions, we have to determine the gas temperature at the exit of the compressor and turbine, and we have to determine back work ratio and the thermal efficiency. Okay. So let me show the solution. So if I draw the ideal diagram, so this is say my TS diagram. For the ideal Breton cycle, processes will be 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we will be having 4 to 1. Okay, so in this diagram you can see my T1 temperature is inlet to the compressor, which is given as 300 Kelvin in the question. Okay, and T3 temperature is my inlet to the turbine, which is given as 1300 Kelvin. These two states are given. Apart from this, it is also given that pressure ratio is nothing but equal to how much? 8. Okay, now what we have to do, first thing we have to determine is temperature at the exit of compressor T2 and at the exit of turbine T4. So these are the first two questions. Second question is we have to determine ratio of back work. So back work we call as nothing but compressor work. So compressor work divided by turbine work is something which is known as the back work ratio. And third thing we have to determine is efficiency of the cycle. So these three questions we have to determine. So now for process 1 to 2, I can clearly write P1 1 minus gamma, T1 gamma equal to P2 1 minus gamma, T2 gamma. Okay. From here, I will be finding T2 by T1 will be nothing but P1 by P2. So P1 by P2 is 1 by Rp to power 1 minus gamma divided by gamma. Okay. Now, if we are considering the air standard assumptions, value of gamma will be nothing but equal to 1.4. And by using this relation, we know the pressure value, we know gamma, we know T1. I'll be finding my value of T2 as nothing but equal to 540 Kelvin. Okay, once I have determined the value of T2, now I can apply same equation from process number 3 to 4. And if I apply same equation from process number 3 to 4, I will be finding value of temperature T4 as nothing but equal to 770 Kelvin. Okay, so now temperatures are known. next part I have to determine is nothing but ratio of the back work. In terms of Breton cycle, what will be happening? Amount of work done, I can write compressor work as nothing but, if I have to write work done on per kg basis, I can write Cp times T2 minus T1. This will be my compressor work, and turbine work will be nothing but Wt equal to Cp times T3 minus T4. Now, if we are considering air as our working medium, value of Cp will be nothing but 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and I know the values of T2, T1, T3, T4. Okay. So by using these equations, if I substitute different values, I'll be finding compressor work as nothing but equal to 244.16 kilojoule per kg, and I'll be finding my turbine work as nothing but 606.60 kilojoule per kg. Okay, and finally, if I calculate the value of Rv, which is nothing but Wc divided by Wt, I am getting value of Rv as 0.403. So you can see that something around 40% of the turbine work is actually being consumed by the compressor when we are operating with all the ideal processes. So till moment we have not considered irreversibilities into account. When we will be considering irreversibility, then our amount of work required by the compressor will be more, and turbine work will be slightly less. So that's why this one back work ratio will be increasing much more significantly. Okay. So now I can determine value of net work done, which will be equal to turbine work minus compressor work. So this will be my amount of net work done. I know efficiency is nothing but equal to efficiency is equal to W net divided by Q input, and Q input for my process will be equal to Cp times T3 minus T2. I know the value of temperatures, so I'll be able to calculate value of heat input as 851.62 kilojoule per kg, and finally value of my efficiency will be close to 42.6%. Okay, so this is we have determined the solution for problem number one. Now let me consider next problem. So what we have in the second question, now we have to assume that compressor efficiency, we have to assume that we are having compressor efficiency, just things are not visible to me, let me, yes. So we have to consider, assume that compressor efficiency of 80%. Okay, so now instead of having isentropic process, we are having compressor efficiency of 80%. Okay, and we have turbine efficiency of 85%. Okay, so our next part is that we are having compressor efficiency of 80% and turbine efficiency of 85%, and based on these two efficiencies, now we have to determine the back work ratio, thermal efficiency, and turbine exit temperature of the gas turbine cycle, which is discussed in problem number one. Okay, so my question, the main statement remains same, but in this main statement now what we have to include, we have to include that compressor and turbine are having efficiency of 80% and 85%, and based on that we have to calculate the new back work ratio, thermal efficiency, and also we have to determine the temperature at the exit of the turbine. Okay, so let me now take up this question. So this is my problem number two. In problem number two, if I write over here the given quantities, compressor efficiency is 80%, turbine efficiency is 85%. Okay, and we have to determine RB, we have to determine efficiency, and we have to also determine value of T4. So these three parameters we want to determine. Okay, so now if we see problem number one, as per problem number one, our ideal cycle, where we were considering that all the processes are internally reversible, our process was 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now, we were having the value of temperature T1 as 300 Kelvin and value of temperature T3 as 1300 Kelvin. So, these are the given quantities. Now, while we will be considering that we are having irreversibility in our compressor as well as the turbine, so because of that my actual process will be 1 to 2 dash inside compressor. So here I will be having point number 2 dash. Okay, and during the expansion over the turbine we will be having point number 4 dash instead of 0.4. okay, so this will be my new cycle. Now if you see, while we have considered the isentropic process, by considering isentropic process, already we have determined value of T2 as nothing but 540 Kelvin, and we have determined value of T4 also. Value of T4 also we have determined as nothing but 770 Kelvin. Okay. So what I am doing, while I am writing these values I have taken from the previous question, because while I am drawing this diagram over here, I am considering actual points as 2 dash and 4 dash, and the point number 2 and 4 as nothing but our isentropic. Okay, so because of this, now we know the compressor efficiency, so let me first correct our work terms in order to determine the back work ratio. Okay, so efficiency of compressor is 80%, so I can write 0.8. that will be equal to nothing but our isentropic work. So that will be equal to isentropic work, let me write isentropic work as WS divided by actual compressor work. So WCS I am writing as compressor isentropic work, and actual work I am writing as say WCA. So WCA is the actual amount of work. Now isentropic work in the previous case we have already determined as 244.16. So that's why I will be able to determine now actual work by dividing that one with the isentropic efficiency. So this will be coming out to be 305.20 kilojoule per kg. Okay, so this will be my actual amount of compressor work. Similarly, if I have to write down the efficiency of the turbine will be nothing but turbine actual work, because turbine is a work producing device, so it will produce less work during the irreversible, divided by isentropic work of the turbine. Okay, so from here if you calculate, you will be finding actual work of the turbine as nothing but equal to 515.61 kilojoule per kg. So if we know these values of actual work of compressor divided by actual work of turbine, that will be giving me my new ratio. So I am calling it as say R dash B, that is actually our back work ratio. Okay, so it will be equal to 0.592. So it means if you are having more irreversibility associated into your cycle, with increase in the amount of irreversibility, our back work ratio will also be increasing. Okay, now next part was we have to determine efficiency. So if we have to determine efficiency, we have to determine amount of heat added, because work we have already calculated, actual compressor work, actual turbine work. So my W dash net will be W turbine actual minus W compressor actual. So that we can easily calculate. But for determining now the actual amount of heat transfer, so you can see now in our cycle including irreversibility, my heat addition process is from 2 dash to 3. So if heat addition is from 2 dash to 3, I have to first determine the temperature of point number 2 dash. So I can also write compressor efficiency as nothing but equal to Cp times T2 minus T1. This is the reversible work of the compressor, divided by Cp times T2 dash minus T1. T2 dash minus T1 is the actual work. Now Cp will be cancelling. This T2, T1 I know, and I know the value of efficiency. So from here I will be getting the value of T2 dash as nothing but equal to 598 Kelvin. Okay, once I have a value of T2 dash as 598 Kelvin, I can calculate the amount of heat added. Amount of heat added will be equal to Cp times T3 minus T2 dash, and this amount will be equal to 790.58 kilojoule per kg. Okay, so this is how we can calculate amount of heat added. Once we know the net amount of work done, as well as the we know now W net and we know Q input, so from here we will be able to get the value of efficiency as 26.6%. Okay, now final part was we have to determine temperature at the exit of the turbine. So at the exit of the turbine, now we have nothing but point number 4 dash. So once again, by using the formulation of efficiency of turbine as Cp times T3 minus T4 dash divided by Cp times T3 minus T4, I can determine the value of temperature T4 dash, and this will be coming out to be 853 Kelvin. Okay, so this is how we can solve our second problem, where we are having irreversibilities, and because of the irreversibilities we have encountered that our back work ratio is actually increasing and efficiency of the cycle has decreased. Okay, now let me take up problem number 3. So problem number 3 is actually once again including This includes the regeneration into our actual cycle. So here we have to determine the thermal efficiency of the gas turbine. Okay, and we have to determine this thermal efficiency for the problem which is described previously. Okay, but one additional thing we are doing, we are considering over here a regenerator, and this regenerator is having effectiveness of 80%. Okay, so now what I am considering, I am considering that I am using one regenerator also, and this regenerator is having actually 80% effectiveness. So by including the regenerator, what will be my efficiency, and that too with the actual cycle. Okay, so now let me show you the solution for problem number 3. So for problem number 3, now effectiveness of heat transfer is actually 80%. That is one additional parameter. This heat transfer is happening inside our heat exchanger. Okay, so now if I draw the cycle, actual cycle, first let me draw the ideal cycle which was there in our problem number 1. So this was 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let me draw the cycle which include irreversibility. So because of the irreversibility, now my point was one mistake I have done. I have drawn it in such a way so that turbine exit temperature is low in comparison to compressor inlet. Okay, so in that case I will not be able to do regeneration, so this I have to keep slightly more. Okay, so say this is 1, 2, 3, 4, then I have actual process, and because of the actual process, in place of point number 2 I am reaching to some point 2 dash, and over here in place of point number 4 I am going to some point 4 dash. Okay, now I am doing actually regeneration. So while I am doing regeneration, this 2 dash point will be actually heated. So this 2 dash point will be heated inside the heat exchanger where we are doing regeneration, and let me say that it is going to some point 5 over here. Okay, so if we are having ideal regeneration, then obviously it should go till 0.4 dash, but if we are having effectiveness of heat exchange process is less than 100%, then it will be stopping somewhere before reaching equal to that of the temperature of 0.4 dash. Okay, which is this 4 dash is now inlet point to the regenerator in the counterflow direction. Okay, so now I can, if I draw this regenerator over here, so this is my regenerator. In this regenerator, one medium is entering at state number 2 dash, and it is being heated till point number 5. And in the other direction, I have another medium which is entering at point number 4 dash, and say it is leaving somewhere over here at point 6. So I have some point number 6 at which our this state of the hot medium is there at the end of the heat exchanger. Okay, regenerator type heat exchanger, and we are having here flow of heat in this direction from this top medium to bottom medium. So one is flowing from left to right, and this is flowing from right to left. So we are having counter flow arrangement. Okay, now what I have to do, I already know the value of point number T2 dash. I already know the value of point number T2 dash. I already know the value of temperature T4 dash. So T4 dash also I know, T2 dash I also I know, and I also know the actual compressor work, I know actual turbine work. So that's why I also know the W dash net amount of work. Whatever net amount of work we are having for actual cycle, that also I know. Now I have to determine efficiency. So what will be the change? The change will be, because we are using regenerator over here, so because of the regenerator, my heating will be now from only point number 5 to point number 3. Okay, so now heat addition process, now it will be only from point number 5 to point number 3, earlier which was from 2 dash to 3. Okay, so that's why this is the only change. Apart from that, everything is same. So now we have to estimate, if we have to determine this amount of heat added, we have to estimate nothing but our temperature T5. Okay, so we need to determine temperature T5, because that will be finally helping us in determining the amount of heat which we are adding into our working medium. Okay. So for this, what we have to do, if you recall my today's lecture, so I have told you that effectiveness of heat transfer is nothing but equal to Q actual divided by Q ideal. So that is the formulation of effectiveness. Now, if you see this particular cycle, in this particular cycle, actual heat transfer is happening from point 2 dash to 5. So that's why I can write Q actual as nothing but equal to Cp times T5 minus T2 dash. So this I can write over here. Okay. And if you see the ideal heat transfer, so ideally what will be happening, if it is entering at point 2 dash, maximum heat will be added only up to the point number 4 dash. Okay. So because of the some inefficiencies in our heat transfer process, we have got this point number 5. But if our heat transfer process is actually 100% effective, in that case, what will be happening? Instead of point number 5, we will be going to point number equivalent temperature to that of point number 4 dash. Okay. So that's why my ideal heat transfer I can call as nothing but T4 dash minus T2 dash. Okay. So that's why ideal heat transfer will be Cp times T4 dash minus T2 dash. Now Cp will be cancelling out T2 dash, T4 dash, T2 dash. We have already determined. We know the value of this effectiveness as 0.8, which is given in our this problem. So from here, I will be easily able to determine the value of T5. Once T5 is known, I can determine Q input as nothing but Cp times, Cp times, you see, now the heat addition process is from 3 to 5. Okay, so 5 to 3 is the heat addition process. So I can write simply amount of heat added, Q in is equal to Cp times T3 minus T5. So this will be my amount of heat added. So this will be equal to 570.60 kilojoule per kg. And now if you calculate the efficiency, you will be finding efficiency as 36.9%. Okay. So it means when we are using this regenerator, our amount of heat addition is actually decreasing. As amount of heat addition is decreasing, we are having some improvement in our efficiency. So while you are considering your actual cycle without regeneration, then efficiency was close to 26%. So upon using the regeneration, we are having significant improvement in efficiency, and new efficiency is actually close to 36.9%, whereas the net amount of work output has remained unchanged. Okay. So it means amount of heat supplied has decreased upon including the regeneration into our cycle. Okay. So now I will stop at this point, and we will have further discussion on doubts.